Today, we take a look at two new Disney Plus films, Black Beauty and Godmother. Come with me on this review journey. So welcome back to Lauren's Adventures Out There, or if you're new, please subscribe to our channel, hit the bell for notifications, and do like this program. I am Lauren, for those of you who have not been here, and I am with Castlescapes and Clones, where we discuss everything in the Disney universe. So today, we are going to be talking about Black Beauty and Godmother, which are two new shows on Disney Plus, and I got an opportunity to watch them yesterday and thought I'd talk about them today. So here we go. We'll start with Black Beauty. Now, I thought this was an excellent film. I can't remember the other Black Beauty films, like the one with Elizabeth Taylor and the there was another one that was done later. The only thing that I can remember from the most recent one is them riding on the, near the ocean. And that's the only thing that I can remember. So this is kind of a fresh look, I think, at the film. It stars Mackenzie Foy, who is goes to live with her uncle. I'm not exactly sure why she goes to live with her uncle, but out on a ranch. And Kate Winslet is the voice of Black Beauty. Not that Black Beauty talks, she just narrates a story. And it goes from her being born to, you know, the end of her life. I don't think that's really any kind of spoilers there for you. Although I will probably be talking about spoilers, so just in case you haven't watched the film and don't want to know anything, maybe come back afterward to check out this program. And anyway, I enjoyed this film quite a bit. I thought that it was a beautiful film. And I thought that Mackenzie Foy did a great job. And I love how her relationship with Beauty grew with her uncle. Because she was at first like really estranged. And she didn't really want to have anything to do with her uncle. And it was kind of like a nice journey for them to have together. And, you know, by the end, she was very close to her uncle. Yeah, which I thought was very nice. It was a very nice part of the story. I thought that it was beautifully narrated by Kate Winslet. I like that touch. I like the fact that Beauty was narrating the story as we went along. But, you know, it's not necessarily a Christmas or holiday film. You know, parts of it are. I think that it's a great film for the holidays, and I think that you should check it out if you haven't had a chance to watch it yet. Just a nice film. I think this film was acquired by Disney Plus, and they're doing a good job at selecting these films that, you know, aren't going anywhere and, you know, bringing them to Disney Plus. I think that, you know, it's a great opportunity for them to have new programming. And again, this one, I think, was just bar none. If you love horses, you know, they're just beautiful, beautiful animals. You'll love this film. And, you know, again, another great film for the holidays, I think. So enjoy. Now on to Godmother. Now, Godmother was, I thought was a fun film. Now, it's not Black Beauty, beautiful kind of film. It's more kind of the way that you would expect Disney to do a film. Like, it's kind of like a Disney Channel film, I think, that they would probably have done it on Disney Channel if they didn't have Disney Plus. You know, it's just one of those films that it could get a little silly at times, but if you like Hallmark Christmas films, I think you'll like this film. I thought that it was just a fun film. Jillian Bell, who plays Eleanor, who is the godmother in question in this film, I thought did a fun job at channeling Amy Adams from Enchanted, that kind of like fish out of water kind of role. I think that maybe she channeled it a little too much, you know, that she got kind of cartoony, and I wish that she hadn't gone to that level. Again, I think that this would have been on Disney Plus. I mean, Disney Channel, sorry. It was on Disney Plus. But it's basically, the story is about this godmother, this young godmother who is going to this godmother school in what is called the motherland. And, you know, everybody says that she's never going to be a godmother. So she kind of like escapes with an assignment to, you know, without anybody knowing, and going to the real world. And, you know, she meets up with Mackenzie, who she's expecting to be a young girl. That Mackenzie is played by Isla Fisher. And, you know, thinks that she's going to be a young girl, and she's a woman. And she's trying to bring her happily ever after, which she knows, you know, like the Cinderella kind, with the prince and the castle and all of this. And she learns that this is not how it operates in the real world. And so, you know, again, it can be a little silly, but I think mostly fun. And a nice, again, holiday movie. And again, if you like Hallmark Christmas films, then I think you'll like this film. And I did. I enjoyed it, and I would probably watch it again. Anyway, that's it. Have you watched any of these films? Comment below and let me know which one is your favorite. And I'd love to know. Thanks so much for watching. Again, we would love it if you would subscribe to our channel and hit the bell for notifications and like this program. It will really help us. So we're a fledgling channel. We're developing new content almost every day, and we would love for you to enjoy it. So definitely check us out and subscribe. All right, so you can always reach me on Twitter at CCC Disney Uni. Or if you want to send me something personally on Twitter, you can go to at Lojav. And you can always visit our website at www.castlescapesandclones.com. Thanks again for joining. Bye!